women by nature are nurturers. They're the ones who bring forth life.
As women, if we are empowered and skilled, we can perform the very best.
At first, when I was categorized as an electrical technician, people wondered how I will work, because I was the first female to be categorized as an electrical technician. But I wanted to prove them wrong. I pulled up my socks until I finished the classes and started working.
I'm the first female chopper pilot in the Kenya Defence Forces.
I'm the first lady to be appointed as a regimental sergeant major, that is RSM, in Defence Forces.
I am the first lady on the fighter pilots in Kenya and also in East and Central Africa. I was the first lady to train in Jordan as a pilot and complete my course. And I was the first lady to set foot in that in the F-5 base in Jordan.
I'm the first female aeronautical engineer in Joint Helicopter Command.
I'm the first lady in the combat engineering.
I'm the chief electrical technician on board this ship, KNS Jasiri.
So every day I wake up in the morning and I know, as a citizen of this country, as an officer commissioned by the president, and as a pilot, I have a duty to my fellow countrymen to make sure that I fulfill the objectives, to fulfill the mission. There is a mission that has been set out by the Air Force, by the Kenya Defence Forces as a whole, and that is my baby. That is what I work towards achieving each and every single day.
Considering it's a male-dominated field, whereby it entails a lot of energy, a lot of devotion, a lot of commitment in actually attaining a day's work. So as ladies out there, let's not be intimidated.
We provide combat support to the combat troops.
My role in Joint Helicopter Command is to command and administer.
My role in combat engineering is demining, EOD operator, explosive ordnance disposal operator, and creating awareness in counter improvised explosive devices.
At School of Military Police, we run courses like police prevention police course, we run the regimental police course, we run VIP police course. Those all courses, they are very important at the side of security.
Women have to rise up to the challenge that's ahead of them. Remember, our grandmothers never had it easy. The women who have been there before, they've had it even more rough than we've had. I hear people talking about women empowerment, but this cannot happen if you do not have it in you to actually perform, outperform yourself.
I've always wanted to be in the aviation industry since I was in high school. Physics was my favorite subject. I remember telling my physics teacher, I'm going to be an aeronautical engineer one day.
Women will inspire. They're the ones who will make men sit down and think about what we need to do. So they have to inspire men in the right direction.
I'm so proud working on board the biggest naval ship, KNS Jasiri, as the chief electrical technician.
As a woman in the military, I take pride that I have a chance to fulfill my task and take up the challenge and serve my country by giving security.
My proudest moment was when the Navy selected me among the few who went to bring the ship KNS Jasiri from Spain in Ribadeo.
My proudest moment as an officer was to be assigned as the first platoon commander, the first female platoon commander.
I want to talk to the girls outside there who are ambitious and want to make their dreams come true. Join the Navy and see the world, and your dreams will come true.
Being the first female chopper pilot in the Kenya Defence Forces, I'm so proud to be the first one in the Kenya Defence Forces. And I would like to encourage the young ladies out there that their passion is to fly, that they can do it. They should believe that they can do it and trust themselves, because it all lies in what they believe in.